Okay, this review has been pending for a while on the sway bars on the F30. So I've got IBAC sway bars installed on this car and it has more or less removed most of my handling woes. So I don't know if you can see them.
Can we see them?
Not from here at least, but yeah, if you open the hood, you should be able to see them. Anyways, we'll take a look at them after I come back from the drive. While we pull this car out of the driveway, let's talk about what anti-roll bars are and what kit I have. So anti-roll bars basically control the body roll of your car to a significant extent. So the factory anti-roll bar allows a lot of body roll in this car, particularly because this is a luxury line. And the uprated anti-roll bars basically do a good job of cancelling out a lot of the body roll. So there are a lot of anti-roll bar kits for these cars, and the one I found most suitable for my application after driving another friend's car were the IBAC anti-roll bar kit. So these come as a kit, front and rear, and the rear is a fixed point, so you can't adjust it. The front is a two-point adjustable. Basically, it means you got three adjustments. Either both the end links on the outermost hole, which is the softest, then one end link on the outermost hole, one end link on the innermost hole, that is the middle setting, and both end links on the innermost hole, that's the hardest setting. So I have the front on the hardest setting right now, and because I like the steering wheel, the feel of the steering wheel a lot, but in case it becomes a little too snappy for you, then you can go to any one of the other settings. So basically what the anti-roll bar on this car is doing is preventing the car from rolling over when I'm turning the car. A result of putting both the anti-roll bars on this car is that the rear anti-roll bar is essentially inducing oversteer, and the front anti-roll bar is inducing understeer. So now you have both understeer and oversteer characteristics on this car very clearly defined from the factory, which with the help of the new one with the IBAC kit, you can fine tune depending on how much you like the car to move around. Now, one thing you'll notice immediately after installing these anti-roll bars is how direct and responsive your steering is. You know, one of the biggest complaints I had on this car was that the steering was extremely unresponsive. It was indirect, it didn't have any feel, and it had a terrible on-center and centering feel. So basically what I mean by on-center is when I turn the steering wheel in either direction, how fast or how automatically does it come back to the center. Now, if you have ever driven an F30 BMW in any guise other than the M3, the on-center steering feel is horrible. That means in the center of the wheel, you can go a lot of play before the car starts to move or turn. That is solved completely. I am on the tightest setting and on the front anti-roll bar, and that's what affects the center steering feel. And on the tightest settings, the steering feel is brilliant. I mean, you know exactly what the front wheels are doing. And mind you, this is with the stock suspension on the car, which means I am on the stock spring and the stock BMW struts, and the steering feel is brilliant. So, you know, for example, if you have the 90 degree turn coming up in front, you'll see, you know, when I turn the wheel and I just let go and I press the gas, the car tries to correct itself and go straight. That phenomena was not there in the stock suspension. So if you had the steering wheel turned and you let go and press the gas, the car would continue to turn, which is a very unsettling behavior. So I'm going to let this auto go so I can do it a little faster. Yeah. So I turn the steering wheel really hard, accelerate, the car comes straight without even touching the steering wheel. This is one of the biggest problems I faced with the F30 as it was in the luxury line, guys, that the steering wheel coming back on center was very, very slow, or in most cases not even there. Now it's brilliant. You know, I can just throw the car in a corner, press the gas, just let go of the steering wheel, it'll come center and the car will correct itself. So that is one of the biggest advantages of the front sway bar on this car. It really sorts out the front. You want the steering wheel to come back even faster than it is, if you're going to drifting and all, then you would need to add a front strut brace on this car. With the front strut brace and the front sway bar, the steering would come back instantly. The rear sway bar is inducing oversteer, which is actually very good in this car, because the way the stock setup of the luxury line is that it induces understeer. On a rear wheel drive car, there was tremendous understeer in the stock configuration, and the iBACs really improved that. So I can literally throw the car in the corner, press the gas, and the tail will come out. Not in a scary way, in a controllable fashion. Now, one of the guys who I met at the track, he also has a F30 BMW, same car essentially, Tanay Poddar. He drove his car on track and he had the exact same experience as I did when I took this car for the first time on track. Was that there was either understeer, or just some weird oversteer which you could not correct. And that was my first and last track day with this car. So see, you know, the car comes around. The car actually follows the corner rather than understeering into it. Unlike in the stock suspension setup. You turn the wheel, you press the gas, the car turns. So there is so much feedback in just one suspension element, it's really mind-boggling. So I turn the... Yeah. And mind you, my traction control is fully on, I'm driving in comfort mode, I'm not even hooning. Literally, the steering wheel just comes back straight, and that is a brilliant feeling. That's how a rear wheel drive car should drive. I mean, most of the E90s I've driven have this ability stock. Now the F30s, God knows for what reason, in India were extremely, extremely soft. So they never had this ability stock. So we figured out that the sway bar would be a good place to start, because this is my daily and I would like to keep it comfortable without adding a heavy set of coilovers on it. Yeah, this car is fun. You know, it's still at the 189 horsepower or whatever the factory tune is for this car. But be very decent torque in the mid-range. Low end toggle also, the top end is completely dead on this car. Yeah, so back to sway bar reviews, right? So the handling of this car is sorted. Earlier there was a huge, I don't know, if you haven't driven an F30 you may not get it, but if you had driven a factory F30 luxury line, or even the sport line for that matter, or the sport, you would have noticed that there's a lag. The entire system of steering the car and the turning of the car, there's a lag. So let's say if I do this, the car is almost taking a few seconds. So you're turning the wheel, the car is not exactly in sync. The body movement is not exactly in sync with what your steering wheel is doing, but there's a lag to it. And that lag was extremely unsettling if you're driving fast. So if you're driving at slow speeds, you won't get that lag much. But if you're driving at higher speeds, then that lag kind of eroded your confidence on the car and you were scared to push it. With the sway bars, because it's controlling the movement of the chassis from left to right and not letting the car lean over either side when I'm turning or when I'm turning the steering, that lag is gone. And it's really confident. I mean, just simply removing that lag makes this car so much more, you know, communicative to the driver compared to the other, compared to what it was stock. So the chassis lag is tremendously improved. So now the front of the car does exactly what you want it to do without, you know, a delay. And you know, so let me just get ahead of this biker. So yeah, so see the car is just following my steering wheel the way it is moving. This behavior wasn't there in the car. This is just because of the sway bar. So the both the front and rear together are controlling the body roll and allowing my chassis to actually follow the road and follow my instruction from the steering wheel rather than it having a lag on it. Let me just put on a mask. I don't know if this is still a thing, but yeah. Another thing you will notice when you put the sway bars in is that the ride comfort remains more or less same. What will change is you'll get a little bit more road feedback from the car because your independent suspension is not as much independent as it was before. So the wheel movement of one wheel is actually transmitted to the other wheel and back into the chassis, which on very bad road is a little irritating at times, but when you're driving normally, like right now, I actually welcome that feedback because it actually tells me that no, my left rear wheel is going over a bump and my right rear wheel is also reacting to that bump. So it's the responsiveness is much more. So let's see if I can do this. Okay. So I'll put it in sport plus mode, turn the AC up, put it in sport. There's a car coming, so what I'll do is I'll wait for this car to go and then I'll turn the wheel aggressively and you'll see what I mean. Okay. So nobody's coming. Good. So now I turn the wheel for me. It starts it out. I didn't even have to put in any feedback. I mean, I didn't even put in any steering feedback. My rear came out. I was on the gas. The moment I, you know, held up the gas a little bit, the car straightened itself out automatically without any input. Now, if this was a stock suspension, I mean, the stock anti-roll bars, this car would have just spun in a circle and hit somebody or destroyed something. That is one of the biggest advantages. The car becomes so much more controllable for a rear wheel drive car and it actually makes it so much fun to drive. And by the way, this is on the stock suspension, so I have not changed the suspension to any aftermarket one. In fact, I have actually changed it to my friend's 328i suspension, the shock absorbers, so because mine were leaking, BMW quality. But yeah, so the engine map is stock, the gearbox map is stock. It's just the car is so much more controllable with these sway bars that body roll is there, but it's extremely limited. And the handling is very predictable. I mean, the way the car behaved, you saw. I'll see if I can do that again over here. Sport mode, sport plus mode, traction control in DTC off. So sort itself out. Yeah, okay, 50. Yeah. So limit. Good. Okay. So yeah, it's extremely controllable. And what you'll notice is the DSC interfered a bit more this time because I was holding the gas a lot longer. If I had held the gas till the car slid and lifted off the gas, DSC wouldn't have involved. The car would automatically straighten itself out the moment I would lift off the gas. And that behavior on a 189 horsepower, what do you call it? How much this car makes, about 300 or 290, 270 Nm torque car, with 285 rear, I think 265 rear section tires I'm running. It's very, very good, you know, it's really comforting. So let's try that again. But okay, so I go a little ahead. Okay, that's, sorry, it's in sport, no wonder it interfered. I'm gonna put it in sport plus. Yeah. So traction control cuts all the fun in these cars. I'll go ahead and take the same U-turn again. Fortunately, today is holy, so no cops around, and the traffic is also pretty less. So, what you, another thing you notice in this car, particularly, especially after this model, is that the little less brake dive, and so here we go. See, comes around perfectly well. Brilliant. I mean, for a stock car to be able to do this on the stock factory map with hugely oversized tires, and there's a reason for these oversized tires, because I'm a little scared of the rear wheel drive car. I've not owned many rear wheel drive cars, and I don't want to end up in a pole, so I put as big tires as possible on this chassis. I think 265 is the rear tire size, 245 is the front tire size. So ideally, with that much grip in the back, this car should understeer like nothing else. But it does very nice slides. And if you're better with the steering wheel than I am, then you can actually control the slide. And this wasn't possible with the stock Suevas. Stock Suevas were absolutely horrible.